Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I am Kiran Bendigeri from Grafosyss IAS. In this video, let's have a look at 7th Standard Science 18th Chapter. It's about wastewater story. Rich in lather, mixed with oil, black-brown water that goes down the drains from sinks, showers, toilets, laundries is dirty. It is called wastewater. So you might have seen gutter water. This is the one. The description is given here. That is rich in lather, mixed with oil, black brown water. Right. So this is dirty. This is called wastewater. Water, our lifeline. Clean water is a basic need of human being. Clean water that is fit for use is unfortunately not available to all. It has been reported that more than 1 billion of our fellow human beings have no access to safe drinking water. Remember, more than 1 billion of our fellow human beings have no access. This accounts for a large number of water related diseases and even deaths. So because of which diseases and even deaths. The increasing scarcity of fresh water due to population growth, pollution, industrial development, mismanagement and other factors. Realizing the urgency of the situation on the World Water Day on 22nd March 2005, the General Assembly of the United Nations proclaimed the period 2005 to 2015 as the International Decade for Action on Water for Life. So World Water Day, 22nd March 2005. Right, International Decade for Action on Water for Life, that is 2005 to 2015. Water for Life. All efforts made during this decade aim to reduce by half the number of people who do not have access to safe drinking water. To reduce from a billion to half billion. Cleaning of water is a process of removing pollutants before it enters a water body or is reused. This process of wastewater treatment is commonly known as sewage treatment. It takes place in several stages. So treatment, sewage treatment takes place in several stages. So we are going to study about it. What is sewage? Sewage is a wastewater released by homes, industries, hospitals, offices and other users. It also includes rainwater that has run down the street during a storm or heavy rain. The water that washes off roads and rooftops carries harmful substances with it. Sewage is a liquid waste. Most of it is water, which has dissolved and suspended impurities. These impurities are called contaminants. So remember, sewage is a liquid waste, which is due to homes, industries, hospitals, offices, etc. And the impurities are called contaminants. We know that sewage is a complex mixture containing suspended solids, organic and inorganic impurities, nutrients, saprotrophic and disease-causing bacteria and other microbes. Organic impurities like human feces, animal waste, oil, urea, pesticides, herbicides, fruit and vegetable waste, etc. Inorganic impurities like nitrates, phosphates, metals, which are used in agriculture and all. Nutrients, phosphorus and nitrogen, bacteria such as which cause cholera and typhoid, other microbes such as which cause dysentery. So these are the impurities in sewage water. Water freshens up an eventful journey. In a home or a public building, generally one set of pipes brings clean water and another set of pipes takes away wastewater. Sludge water kitchen, foul waste toilets, waste industrial and commercial organizations. So observe carefully the samples in all the test tubes. So these are the waste obtained from these things, collect it and have a look at it. Do not taste, just smell them. Now answer the following questions. What changes did you observe? Did aeration change the odor and sand filter? This is the activity given in a textbook, which we don't need as of now. Let's have a look at the points which are most important, right? Wastewater treatment plant. Treatment of wastewater involves physical, chemical and biological process, which remove physical, chemical and biological matter that contaminates the wastewater. So we just saw what are the waste particles which are present in sewage water, that is that may be stone or mud, or chemicals like nitrates, phosphates, or biological matter like microorganisms which causes diseases, right? So we have to remove all these things, and we can do this by physical, chemical and biological process. Wastewater is passed through bar screens. Large objects like racks, sticks, cans, plastic packets, napkins are removed. So bar screens. So this is the first step. Water then goes to a grit and sand removal tank. So we have to remove grit and sand, right? The speed of the incoming wastewater is decreased due to allow sand, grit and pebbles to settle down, right? So this is the next step. The water is then allowed to settle in a large tank which is sloped towards the middle. Solids like feces settle at the bottom and are removed with a scraper. This is the sludge. So this is the third step in which sludge is removed. Sludge is the stuffs which are solid matters which are settled down after it is allowed to settle for some time. A skimmer removes the floatable solids like oil and grease, right? By scraper we remove the sludge, and by skimmer we remove the floatable solids like oil and grease. Water so cleared is called clarified water. At this step, it is called as clarified water. The sludge is transferred to a separate tank where it is decomposed by the anaerobic bacteria. The biogas produced in the process can be used as a fuel or can be used to produce electricity. So sludge is decomposed by the anaerobic bacteria, then gas is produced and it is used as a fuel or to produce electricity. Air is pumped into the clarified water to help aerobic bacteria to grow. Anaerobic in the absence of air, aerobic it is in the presence of air, right? Bacteria consume human waste, food waste, soaps and other unwanted matter still remaining in the clarified water. After several hours, the suspended microbes settle at the bottom of the tank as activated sludge. The water is then removed from the top. The activated sludge is about 97% water. The water is removed by sand drying beds or machines. Dried sludge is used as manure, returning organic matter and nutrients to the soil. The treated water has a very low level of organic material and suspended matter. It is discharged into a sea, a river, or into the ground. Nature cleans it up further. Sometimes it may be necessary to disinfect water with chemicals like chlorine and ozone before releasing it into the distribution system. So at the end stage, chlorine or ozone is used to disinfect water before releasing it into distribution system like tanks and distributing to houses through pipes. So sometimes we can feel the chlorine smell in the fresh water which we get from tap. Waste generation is a natural part of human activity, but we can limit the type of waste and quantity of waste produced. Often we have been repelled by offensive smell. The sight of open drains is disgusting. The situation worsens in the rainy seasons when the drains start overflowing. We have to wade through the mud pools on the roads. Most unhygienic and unsanitary conditions prevail. Flies, mosquitoes and other insects breed in it. Right. The water in a river is cleaned naturally by processes that are similar to those adopted in a wastewater treatment plant. In a river, water is cleaned naturally by processes which are similar to the techniques which are used in wastewater treatment plant. But it happens within some limit. After some limit, the river water gets polluted. Aerator. It has been suggested that we should plant eucalyptus trees as all along sewage ponds. These trees absorb all surplus wastewater rapidly and release pure water vapor into the atmosphere. So this is one technique by which we can reduce the wastewater, which absorb all surplus wastewater and release pure water vapor into the atmosphere. So what is aerator? Aerators are various devices used for aeration or mixing air with another substance such as soil or water. Right. So it is the device used for mixing air into soil or water. Aerators can be used to mix what we call chlorine or ozone into water to disinfect it. Insist that the open drains be covered. If the sewage of any particular house makes the neighborhood dirty, you should request them to be more considerate about others' health. Use tea leaves, solid food remains, soft toys, cotton, sanitary towels, etc. should also be thrown in the dustbin. These wastes choke the drains. They do not allow free flow of oxygen. This hampers the degradation process. So these are the solid things which have to be separated and thrown in the dustbin. If we throw into drains, it will choke it and it will also hampers the natural degradation process. Better degradation, better housekeeping practices. One of the ways to minimize or eliminate waste and pollutants at their source is to see what you are releasing down the drain. Cooking oil and fats should not be thrown down the drain. They can harden and block the pipes. In an open drain, the fats clog the soil pores, reducing its effectiveness in filtering water. Throw oil and fats in the dustbin. So remember, oil and fats should be separated and should be kept in dustbin. Chemicals like plants, solvents, insecticides, motor oil, medicines may kill microbes that help purify water. So do not throw them down the drain. So these are the chemicals which kills the microbes, which naturally purifies the water. So we should not mix with the water, which should not be thrown into drain. Sanitation and disease. Poor sanitation and contaminated drinking water is the cause of a large number of diseases. A very large fraction of our people defecates in the open, on dry riverbeds, on river, railway tracks, near fields, and many a time directly in water. Untreated human excreta is a health hazard. It may cause water pollution and soil pollution. Both the surface water and groundwater get polluted. Groundwater is a source of water for wells, tube wells, springs, and many rivers, as we learnt in chapter 16. Thus, it becomes the most common route for waterborne diseases. They include cholera, typhoid, polio, meningitis, hepatitis, and dysentery. So, remember these diseases, which are caused because of water. The bacteria in water, right? Cholera, typhoid, polio, meningitis, hepatitis, dysentery. These are the diseases which are caused due to polluted water. Vermi processing toilet. A design of a toilet in which human excreta is treated by earthworms has been tested in India. It has been found to be a novel, low water use toilet for safe processing of human waste. The operation of the toilet is very simple and hygienic. The human excreta is completely converted to vermicakes, a resource much needed for soil. So, in vermi processing toilet, earthworms are used to treat human excreta, right? This is very simple and hygienic. It is after the conversion, it can be used as vermicakes. It can be used as fertilizers in the agriculture. These things are found in villages, and you might have seen in TV advertisements also about this vermi processing toilet. Alternative arrangement for sewage disposal. To improve sanitation, low-cost on-site sewage disposal systems are being encouraged. Examples are septic tanks, chemical toilets, composting pits, etc. Septic tanks are suitable for places where there is no sewerage system, for hospitals, isolated buildings, or a cluster of 4 to 5 houses. So septic tanks can be used where there is no sewerage system is available. Some organizations offer hygienic on-site human waste disposal technology. These toilets do not require scavenging. Excreta from the toilet seats flow through cover drains into a biogas plant. The biogas produced is used as a source of energy. So some organization provide these kind of technologies, right, which are converted into biogas, which in turn can be used as a fuel. Sanitation at public places. In our country, fairs are organized periodically. A large number of people participate in them. In the same way, railway station, bus, depots, airports, hospitals are very busy places. Thousands of people visit them daily. Large amount of waste is generated here. It must be disposed of properly, otherwise epidemics could break out. Right. The government has laid down certain standards of sanitation, but unfortunately, they are not strictly enforced. However, all of us can contribute in maintaining sanitation at public places. We should not scatter litter anywhere. If there is no dustbin inside, we should carry the litter home and throw it in the dustbin. So these are the common things which we have to, the sensical things which we have to do. we should not throw the litter anywhere. We should throw the waste materials only in the dustbin. Right. Conclusion. We all have a role to play in keeping our environment clean and healthy. You must realize your responsibility in maintaining the water sources in a healthy state. Adopting good sanitation practices should be our way of life. As an agent of change, your individual initiative will make a great difference. Influence others with your energy, ideas, and optimism. A lot can be done if people work together. There is great power in collective action. Right. Mahatma Gandhi once said, "No one need to wait for anyone else to adopt a human and enlightened course of action." Right. Keywords which we just saw: aeration. It is a process in which gas is mixed with soil or water. Right. Aerobic bacteria, anaerobic bacteria. Biogas, contaminant, sanitation, sewage, sewer, sewerage, sludge, wastewater. And what we learned, used water is wastewater. Wastewater could be reused. Wastewater is generated in homes, industries, agricultural fields, and in other human activities. This is called sewage. Sewage is a liquid waste which causes water and soil pollution. Wastewater is treated in a sewage treatment plant. Treatment plants reduce pollutants in wastewater to a level where nature can take care of it up to some extent. Where underground sewerage systems and refuse disposal systems are not available, the low-cost on-site sanitation system can be adopted. So where there is no sewerage system, we can use low-cost on-site sanitation system in which a pit is dug and it is connected with pipes. Byproducts of wastewater treatment are sludge and biogas. Open drain system is a breeding place for flies, mosquitoes, and organisms which cause diseases. We should not defecate in the open. It is possible to have safe disposal of excreta by low-cost methods. So these are the points we read in this chapter. An early engineering fate. Indus Valley Civilization. One of the ancient civilizations, Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, had perhaps the world's first urban sanitation system. So these were much advanced. We are going to study much about them in history books, right? Within the city, individual houses or groups of houses obtained water from wells. There was a separate room for bathing, and wastewater was directed to the covered drains which lined the major streets. The oldest toilet made of bricks is about 4,500 years old. So this is the end of the chapter. Thank you.